Hello friends, this is part 2, AIIMS important questions which have high probability in appearing in NEET PG. Okay, this video covers 100 one-liners. In entire human genome, coding DNA constitutes 2%. So in entire human genome, coding DNA is only 2%. Phosphoglucomutase enzyme is common between glycogenesis and glycogenolysis. So what is the most what is a common enzyme between glycogenesis and glycogenolysis? It is phosphoglucomutase. Cholecystokinin increases gallbladder contraction after a fatty meal. So cholecystokinin increases gallbladder contraction after a fatty meal. The cells of the human body most sensitive to ischemia are neurons. So what are the cells of human body most sensitive to ischemia? Neurons. Okay. Mean circulatory pressure defines the pressure in the vascular system in the absence of blood flow. So mean circulatory pressure is pressure of vascular system where there is no blood flow. Increase in pH, that is alkalosis, can cause shift of oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve to shift to left. So increase in pH shifts the oxygen dissociation curve to left. So left shift of oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve is due to increased pH. And other causes are decrease in temperature, decrease in 2,3 dpg and decrease in H plus ion. And carbon monoxide also shifts the oxygen dissociation curve to left side. So that is important bit. Carbon dioxide shifts the oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve to left side. So obviously the opposite of it is right shift. Right shift is increase in temperature, increase in 2,3 dpg, increase in H plus ion and decrease in pH. And reduced affinity also shifts to right side. Okay, reduced affinity also shifts to right side. Fast fatigue fibers are recruited during walking in the end. The fast fibers are recruited. The mechanostretch receptors in joints and ligaments are slow adapting. So mechanostretch receptors are slow adapting. Golgi tendon organ senses muscle tension. Okay, nuclear bag fibers are related to length and velocity. So nuclear bag fibers are related to length and velocity. So fast fibers are recruited at the end of walking. Mechanostretch fibers are slow adapting. Golgi tendon organs are used for sensory organs for muscle tension. Nuclear bag fibers are related to length and velocity. Facial nerve gives out secretomotor fibers to lacrimal gland, submandibular gland and nasal gland. So facial nerve gives out secretomotor fibers to lacrimal gland, submandibular gland and nasal gland. Dural venous sinuses lie outer to the meningeal layer, that is between outer endosteal and inner meningeal layers. Inferior rectal vein is not enclosed in visorectal fascia. The most common variant in the blood supply of colon is absent right colon artery. So this is the most common variant in the blood supply of colon, that is right colic artery is absent. Major part of venous drainage from the esophagus is by azygous vein and inferior thyroid and left gastric vein. So for the esophagus, what are the venous drainage? Azygous vein and inferior thyroid and left gastric veins. Okay. Buccopharyngeal membrane develops from both ectoderm and endoderm. So buccopharyngeal membrane develops from both ectoderm and endoderm. Erector pili is a smooth muscle in the dermis, derived from lateral plate mesoderm. So erector pili is from dermis and from mesoderm. Disulfiram should not be given in alcohol dependent patients as it can cause severe disulfiram ethanol reaction. Okay, it is used in the patients who are already counseled and ready to reduce the alcohol content, and they are ready to wean off from the alcohol. So chronic alcohol dependent patients. Most effective treatment modality for post traumatic stress disorder is cognitive behavioral therapy. Investigation of choice for evaluation of acute head injury is non contrast CT. So acute head injury you do non contrast CT. First investigation done in a person suspected to have retained piece of glass in the finger is plain radiograph. Mapleson A is breathing circuit of choice for spontaneous ventilation. Remember, Mapleson A is breathing choice for spontaneous ventilation. Succinyl choline is a short acting depolarizing muscle relaxant which causes initial fasciculations during induction. Okay, it causes it's a short acting depolarizing muscle relaxant which causes fasciculations during induction, it can cause muscle soreness, post-operative muscle pain. Panniculus adiposus is present in the whole body except eyelids, penis, scrotum. Okay, so this is panniculus adiposus is present in the whole body except in the loose skin where loose fat is there, like eyelid, loose skin is there, eyelids, penis and scrotum. Lichen scrofulosorum is a type of cutaneous TB. An elderly male presents with T3N0 laryngeal carcinoma. The treatment is concurrent chemo radiotherapy. So for laryngeal carcinoma, we give chemo radiotherapy. Electrocochleography is a gold standard investigation for diagnosis of Meniere's disease. This is electrocochleography. So what's the gold standard for treatment of Meniere's disease? It is electrocochleography. Okay. Adenoidectomy results in hypernasality. Rebound tonometer is used as a self-tonometer. Okay. Rebound tonometer is used as a self-tonometer. Adenoidectomy causes hypernasality. Gonioscopy is not done in a dilated pupil. Gonioscopy is used to test the internal drainage of the eye, whether it is normal or not. They will see the anterior chamber angle and all with gonioscopy. So it is not done in case of dilated pupil. A number of cataract surgeries leading to sight restoration is output indicator for NPCB. Okay. So NPCB is National Program for Control of Blindness. So number of cataract surgeries leading to restoration of sight is a indicator. Normal value of Arden index is 185%. So Arden index is used for the interpretation of electrooculogram, that is EOG. That is 185%. Subretinal demarcation line indicate old regmatogenous retinal detachment. So subretinal demarcation is nothing but subretinal demarcation indicates regmatogenous old retinal detachment. A laser trabeculoplasty is indicated in pseudo-exfoliative glaucoma. So pseudo-exfoliative glaucoma, you do laser trabeculoplasty. Silver sulfadiazine can be used in the treatment of fungal keratomycosis. So what do you use in fungal keratomycosis? You use silver sulfadiazine. The most likely diagnosis in a 25-year-old young adult with painless red eye with intraocular pressure of 60 mmHg is glaucomatocyclitic crisis. Okay, for 25-year-old when there is painless red eye but IOP is 160, okay, then it is called glaucomatocyclic crisis. In hypoxic injury, the cornea becomes edematous because of accumulation of lactate. Okay, so edema of cornea is due to accumulation of lactate in hypoxic injury. Gene commonly indicated in congenital cataract is CryGS3. Okay, CryGS3. This is congenital cataract. H-reflex is useful in the diagnosis of SI radiculopathy. H-reflex is used for sacroiliac radiculopathy. TB meningitis is not absolute contraindication for corneal transplantation. Okay. So, TB meningitis is not an absolute contraindication for corneal transplantation. Bone dysplasia is invariably seen in development defect. The most likely diagnosis in a 40-year-old female presenting with multiple lytic bone lesions, fracture clavicle and periosteal resorption of second and third metatarsals is hyperparathyroidism. So fractures are there, multiple lytic bony lesions are there, periosteal resorption is there and second and third metatarsals is resorption is seen. So it is hyperparathyroidism. Most common joint involved in gout is metatarsophalangeal joint, that is MTP. Diagnosis in a 40-year-old male who presents with acute onset of pain and swelling of left great toe and punched out lesion of the phalanx and overhanging edges of the x-ray is gout. So this is very important, overhanging edges on x-ray. Okay, they'll give this in the question, overhanging edges on of the x-ray. And punched out lesion can be seen in many things, but punched out lesion of phalanx, that is the finger joint, and swellings of left great toe. Left great toe. Great toe is mostly commonly involved in gout. Ankylosing spondylitis has association with HLA B27. So we read in one of the video, I explained the code is PAIR for HLA B27, that is psoriasis, and this is ankylosing spondylitis, inflammatory bowel disease and Reuter's syndrome. Okay, the most likely diagnosis in a 10-year-old who presents with a mild tibial swelling and lytic lesion with sclerotic margins on the x-ray is osteoid osteoma. So 10-year-old child presents with mild tibial swelling and lytic lesion with sclerotic margins in the x-ray, that is osteoid osteoma. So there will be lytic, both lytic and sclerotic lesions. So sclerotic will be at the margins and inside it will be lytic lesions. Okay, and it commonly involves tibia. It is osteoid osteoma and it occurs in children. A person is hemiplegic and bedridden for 1 year. Changes in bone mineral density are first seen in proximal humerus. So hemiplegic and bedridden for 1 year. So bone mineral density changes are first seen in proximal humerus. Okay. In the karyotype, there is a deletion of chromosome number 5. Okay, which leads to Kredichat syndrome. So chromosome number 5, I will cover the chromosome disorders in a very short video, like 1 minute video. Okay. 1 or 2 minutes. In the karyotype, there is deletion of chromosome number 5, which leads to Kredichat number. So chromosome number 5 is affected in Kredichat syndrome. The most likely diagnosis in a neonate presenting with respiratory distress with enlargement of left upper lobe of lung and mediastinal shift towards the right is congenital lobar emphysema. So the neonate presents with respiratory distress and the enlargement is in the left upper lobe of the lung. So mediastinum shifts towards the right side. It is congenital lobar emphysema. Conjugated bilirubinemia is seen on day 10 of the life. If it is seen on the day 10 of the life, then it is worrisome. Okay. Attention and concentration is mediated by frontal lobe of cerebral cortex. So attention and concentration by frontal lobe of cerebral cortex. Patch clamp is used to study current flow across a single ion channel. Free nerve endings carrying nociceptive fibers are seen in mesentery. So free nerve endings carrying nociceptive fibers are seen in mesentery. Okay. Free nerve endings in mesentery, nociceptive fibers. Okay. Patch clamp is for current flow across ion channel. Desmosine is a component of elastin. Remember, desmosine is a component of elastin, not collagen. Presence of HBS. Okay. Underlies the major pathological manifestations like chronic hemolysis, microvascular occlusions and tissue damage. Digoxin does not cause edema. Time dependent killing with prolonged PAE, that is AUC by MIC. So PAE is post antibiotic effect. So PAE is equals to AUC is the area under the curve. They do some picture and a graph maybe. That is area under the curve by minimal inhibitory concentration of the drug. So time dependent killing with prolonged PAE is seen in the following drugs. Okay, azithromycin, clindamycin, telithromycin, lenizolid, macrolides, tetracyclines and streptogramine and tegicycline. Okay, so prolonged PAE is in azithromycin, clindamycin, telithromycin, lenalidomide, macrolides, tetracycline, streptogramine, tegicycline. Dexmedetomidine is a centrally active selective alpha 2 agonist that has been introduced for sedating critically ill ventilated patients in intensive care units. It also is being used as an adjunct to anesthesia, analgesia and sedation are produced. Analgesia and sedation are produced with little respiratory depression. Sympathetic response to stress and noxious stimuli is blunted. It is administered by IV infusion. So they are just telling dexmedetomidine is a centrally active alpha 2 agonist and it is introduced for sedating critically ill patients in ICU. It is also used as an adjunct in anesthesia. Analgesia and sedation are also produced with little respiratory depression. Just for you, just remember, it is for ICU patients for sedating drugs, meditomidine, and it is a alpha 2 agonist. It is given IV. Serum level of 2 milli equivalents per liter is suggestive of lithium toxicity. So lithium toxicity is 2 milli equivalents per liter. FDA approved indications for lithium are treatment of acute mania, prophylaxis of bipolar mood disorders, and so in two conditions, acute mania and bipolar mood disorders. Lithium should be stopped 2 days before surgery. So just remember, lithium is 2 milli equivalents per liter in the body is toxic, and it should be stopped 2 days before surgery. The role played by major histocompatibility complex 1 and 2 is presenting antigens for recognition by T cell antigen receptors. So MHC 1 and 2 present antigens for the recognition of antigens by T cell antigen receptors. Population attributable risk is defined as the difference between incidence in population and incidence in non-exposed compared to incidence in population. So they are just saying it is incidence in population minus incidence in non-exposed by incidence in total population. So they are comparing exposed, almost it comes to like exposed by total population. And in 2 into 2 contingency table, the formula of it is given as A by A plus B minus C by C plus D. So it is A by A plus B minus C by C plus D. This is population attributable risk. Most efficient larva control method to prevent transmission of urban malaria is cleaning of drains. So you should clean the drains. Human rights for mentally ill are not an objective of Mental Health Act. So human rights is not an objective of Mental Health Act 1987. Okay. Lamivudine is not used in the treatment of dengue. District collector is a chairman of District Blind Control Society. Coefficient of variation is used to compare two data sets taken on two different scales of measurements. There is no clinical significance of Chandler index. HRCT is investigation choice for bronchiectasis. ASLVO is a marker of recent streptococcal infection. So ASLVO is a marker of recent streptococcal infection. Penicillin hypersensitivity reaction is an example of type 2 antibody mediated hypersensitivity. So penicillin hypersensitivity is type 2 hypersensitivity. Inability to perform physical activity without discomfort falls under NYHA class 4. So inability to perform physical activity without discomfort, okay, falls under NYHA class 4. High calcium intake leads to milk alkali syndrome. So high calcium intake can lead to milk alkali syndrome. In IgM, anti-HBC is diagnosis of acute hepatitis B infection. Staphylococcus aureus is the most common cause of post-influenza pneumonia. So post-influenza pneumonia, Staphylococcus aureus is the most commonest cause. Okay. Non-specific interstitial pneumonia is associated with good prognosis. So non-specific associated with good prognosis. Most common location of MALT, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue, is ileum. So MALT mostly in ileum. Mid-diastolic murmur, opening snap and loud S1 are heard in chronic mitral stenosis, but not the third heart sound. Third heart sound is not heard, but opening snap is seen, loud S1 is seen, and mid-diastolic murmur is seen in mitral stenosis. Patient of aortic stenosis has dyspnea, syncope and angina. So patient of aortic stenosis have dyspnea, syncope and angina. Pulmonary stenosis is usually not seen in rheumatic heart disease. So pulmonary stenosis, which is not seen in rheumatic heart disease, is pulmonary stenosis. Next, tricuspid stenosis. Next list is tricuspid stenosis. This is a repeat question. Just remember, pulmonary stenosis is not seen in rheumatic heart disease. And angina and syncope and dyspnea are seen in aortic stenosis. Artesunate is the most effective treatment of severe malaria. Goserelin is used for the treatment of advanced prostate cancer. So goserelin is used for the treatment of advanced prostate cancer goes through and FNAC cannot detect follicular carcinoma. This is important. FNAC is not used for follicular carcinoma. Hamartomas polyps, that is usually less than 100 throughout the GIT, most common in jejunum. So hamartomas polyps are usually in the jejunum and they are less than 100. If it is more than 100, then you call as familial adenomatous polyposis, FAP. Investigation of choice for acute appendicitis in children is ultrasound. The first priority of management of case of trauma is airway maintenance. Gram-negative bacteria stain red on gram staining. Okay. So gram-negative, gram staining red. Okay. Folic acid and vitamin B12 are essential for ameliorating the toxicity of pemetrexed. Okay. So pemetrexed toxicity, what do you give? You give folic acid and B12. Okay. Pemetrexed. You give folic acid and B12. Ethionamide is associated with hypothyroidism. So ethionamide causes hypothyroidism. Lamivudine is nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So NRTI. What is lamivudine? It is a nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor and it is a NRTI. Time dependent killing and prolonged post antibiotic effect is seen with clindamycin. We saw the list of the drugs, azithromycin, clindamycin and all those things. Okay. Epinephrine is having both alpha and beta agonist property. Bromocriptine has led to worsening of vasospasm, especially in patients with peripheral vascular disease. So bromocriptine can lead to peripheral vascular disease, worsening of symptoms in peripheral vascular disease. Lisinopril is lysine derivative of enalapril, an active metabolite. So lisinopril is lysine derivative of enalapril, an active metabolite. Okay. Verrucoid bodies are seen in schwannoma. ARDS is due to defect of endothelial cells. PCAM, that is PECAM, PCAM and CD31 is responsible for transmigration of leukocytes through endothelium, not the neutrophil activation. PCAM and CD31 is responsible for transmigration of leukocytes through endothelium. The last to receive electrons in electron transport system is oxygen. Methylation of cystosine leads to decreased expression of gene. So methylation of cystosine leads to decreased expression of gene. Last to receive electrons in electron transport is oxygen. PCAM and CD31 are responsible for transmigration of leukocytes through endothelium. Okay. Transmigration of leukocytes through endothelium. ARDS is due to defect in endothelial cells. So just remember the list: azithromycin, clindamycin, telithromycin, linezolid, macrolides, tetracycline, streptogramin and tigecycline. These are having prolonged post-antibiotic effect. They are just asking the repeated questions. I am just reading it again. Azithromycin, clindamycin, telithromycin, linezolid, macrolides, tetracycline, streptogramin and tigecycline. Okay, this completes the AIIMS 100 bits which are important. So I'll come up with the next video. Keep reading. Good luck.